This video is going to be about evaluating logarithmic expressions. So what we're going to do is take a logarithmic expression and figure out what it equals. And what I've got here is that kind of conversion formula that we've done before. So we can remember that if I have a logarithm, like log base b of a equals x, I can convert that to b to the x power equals a. And we're going to use that formula for just about every one of these problems. So let's say, for a first problem, that we're told that we've got the log base 3 of 27, and we want to find out what that equals. Well, I'm going to say that what that equals is x. And now I want to find out what the x is. So I'm going to convert this log base 3 of 27 equals x to the exponential form. So I'll write that as 3, which was my base of my logarithm, so it's going to be the base for my exponent. 3 raised to the x power equals 27. And now all I have to do is ask myself, what power do I have to raise 3 to in order to get 27? Well, 3 to the first power is 3, 3 to the second power is 9, and 3 to the third power is 27. So that means x must equal 3. So the log base 3 of 27 equals 3. Let's try another one. Let's say I have the log base 7 of 49. So I'm going to write log base 7 of 49 equals x, and now I'll convert that. I'll take this base 7, raise it to the x power, and that equals 49. So 7, oh, this is easy, 7 squared is 49. So that means x must equal 2. Okay? Let's try something a little more difficult. What if I have the log base 2 of a fraction, 1/8. Okay, well, I'm going to do the same procedure. I'm going to write that as the log base 2 of 1/8 equals x, and now I want to convert that to exponential form. So I'm going to write 2 to the x equals 1/8. Now let's think about this a second. I'm dealing with 2s as my base. So I want to see, I'm looking at that 8, and what I realize is 8 is the same as 2 to the 1/3. So in other words, I can write 2 to the x equals 1 over 2 to the 1/3. I'm sorry, 2 to the 3rd, because 2 to the 3rd is 8. So 1 over 2 to the 3rd is 1 over 8. Okay? And now I've got a fraction on the left side, on the right side, but just this 2 to the x on the left side. So let's take this fraction, 1 over 2 to the 3rd, and move that 2 to the 3rd to the numerator. So that's going to be 2 to the x equals 2 to the negative 3. So that means that x must equal negative 3. Now I can go back to my problem and write that the answer is negative 3. Okay? Let's try one with a fraction as the base of the log. So what if I have the log base 1/3 of 27. So I'm going to say that equals x, and that means that 1/3 raised to the x power equals 27. So let's raise 1/3 to the x power. Well, 1 to any power is 1, so that means I'm going to have 1 over 3 to the x. and that equals 27. So I want to think in terms of threes. Well, 27 is 3 to the third. So 1 over 3 to the x equals 3 to the third. And now I've got this fraction on the left side. So what I want to do, since I've got an x down here and I don't want to change that x, I want to change the right side into a fraction. So I can turn that into 1 over 3 to the x equals 1 over 3 to the negative 3. And now what I've got is two fractions that are exactly the same, except in one I've got an x, the other one I've got a negative 3. So x must be the same as negative 3. So the log base 1/3 of 27 equals negative 3. Okay? Here's one more. Let's do one with just the log of, what is this number? The log of 100,000. Okay, so that equals x. Now remember, if I haven't written a base, it means the base is 10. So that means I'm going to say 10 to the x power equals 100,000. Now, a very simple thing to do, if you've got 10 to some power equals some number, a 1 and a bunch of zeros, just count the zeros, and that's what the power is. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. That means that the x, the power, is 5. Okay, so this is basically the process of evaluating logarithmic expressions. Most of the time, they're fairly easy. When you end up with things like fractions and negative numbers, you have to take your time and think about it so you can get the right answer. So what you might want to do is go back and look at the parts of the video where I did the fractions both as the base of a log and as the argument of the logarithm. Okay, just to make sure that you're comfortable with those. And then when you go on and do your homework, you should be able to follow that same procedure. Okay, take care. I'll see you next time.